As you can tell, Ron's got his electric bass today. Welcome everyone to this place, this time and this place. This is a holy time, holy place. It's a place where we celebrate in our way the Sabbath. Which was a way of taking rest, but not not just to relax, but to rest, to take a break, to take a pause, to take a moment. In this case, once a week, to reflect on life, because we get distracted, we get pushed and pulled, we get worried and concerned about many things in our lives. But one thing that's absolutely true is that you are here. The question is, are you fully here? Because your body's here, our bodies are here, our bodies can't be anywhere else but here at this point. But our minds, oh, they can be anywhere. Our minds can be anywhere. It can feel like they're everywhere but here. But to get the most out of life, is to develop the practice of becoming present in our minds and letting those things that push and pull us into different places, especially places of worry and of fear, places where we feel inadequate, incapable, unlovable, unprepared. We can let go of those and just become present right here with our body. And so I invite us to do that. Without any fancy technique, but just to let go, not to try to be present, but just to let go of what makes us not present. Just to let go. You're thinking about this and you're thinking about that. You're off to the rest of the day, the rest of the week. Just let it go for a moment. Let it go. And in that way, we enter Sabbath together. We enter a kind of holy rest. Welcome. We remember the beautiful promises of baptism. Page 95.
By the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the fountain of living water, the rock who gave us birth, our light, and our salvation. Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are clothed with God's mercy and forgiveness, you took delight. We praise you for the gift of water that sustains life, and above all, we praise you for the gift of new life in Jesus Christ. Shower us with your Spirit and renew our lives with your forgiveness, grace, and love. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
We sing our opening hymn, Lift High the Cross. Words are on the insert. Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Kyrie 157. Thank you. God is in you. Renew our hearts. O Spirit of life, renew our hearts. Help us let go of all those things that clutter. That lead us to worry and to grasping. Ultimately to a sense of loss. Help us to let go. Of those agreements that we have made within our hearts about who we are and what we are. Help us to let go. That we may experience the genuine life that you have given us. That we may know beyond doubt that we are valued. Beyond doubt that we are loved. And that the spirit by which we live is you. Gospel according to Luke. Now large crowds were traveling with him, and he turned and he said to them, "Whoever comes to me and does not hate father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, yes, even life itself, cannot be my disciple. Whoever does not carry a cross and follow me cannot be my disciple. For which of you, intending to build a tower, does not first sit down and estimate the cost to see whether there is enough to complete it? Otherwise, when the foundation is laid and he's not able to finish, all who see it will ridicule him, saying, 'This fellow began to build and was not able to finish.' Or what king, going out to war against another king, will not first sit down and consider whether he is able with 10,000 to oppose the one who comes against him with 20,000? If he cannot, then while the other is still far away, he sends a delegation and asks for terms of peace. So, therefore, none of you can become my disciple unless you give up all that you have. Salt is good, but if salt has lost its saltiness, how can it be restored? It's fit neither for soil nor for the manure pile. They throw it away. Let anyone with ears, let them hear." The Holy Gospel. Strong words, but I would argue they are like salt in a wound. Intended not just to sting, but to heal. For that's what salt in a wound does. Salt is antibiotic, as I think you know. So salt in a wound means the intention, the ultimate intention, is healing, even though it stings. It's like iodine that way. These words, strong words, are not intended only to hurt, but to heal. And in them, hard as they are to even listen to, is the secret to life itself. So you cannot be my disciple unless you give up all that you have. Whoever does not hate their father, their mother, their wife, or their children, their brother or sister, cannot be my disciple. The word disciple just means learner in Greek. Cannot be my learner. And whoever does not pick up and carry a cross and follow me cannot be my disciple. And whoever does not hate life itself cannot be my disciple. Did Jesus hate his own mother? You saw it in the Gospel of John. He looks down, he says to John, "Behold your mother, take care of her." Or do you think that Jesus was saying, you know what, we really should just like really build crosses and carry them? The passage is meant to offend us in the outward sense so that we might be able to open up to the inner truth. And he says it so many times and in so many ways in different places in the Gospels. He says, "Why are you anxious? Your life does not consist. Why do you worry about what you will eat and what you will wear? Is not life more than these things?" Or to the rich man who had a bountiful harvest and said, "I know what I'll do. I'll tear down my barn and build a bigger barn, and I'll be able to rest and relax for the rest of my days. Wonderful." And then God says, "You fool, this night your soul is required of you." And then Jesus asked the rhetorical question, "Where will all his wealth go?" So what we do, what we all do, is we become attached to what we have, or at least what we think we have. And that doesn't need to be material, but it includes material things. But it can be just our image of who we think we are. We've become attached. We attach to things that people say to us and about us. Whether praise or something negative, and we attach, and those become ours. We attach ourselves to what people think of us, and we attach to other people. And we come to think that these constitute our life. So although it sounds like Jesus is saying something very, very hard to do, hate your family, or at least let go of your attachment to your family, be willing to lay down your life, be willing to let go of your own life so that No one can hold you in terror. Nobody can terrify you. Nobody can make you afraid because you've already let go. It seems like he's asking us to do something so hard it seems impossible. But I'll tell you what, not only is it possible, but it's natural, and it's far easier than the other alternative. Because you know what's hard? Is to hold on to what you think you have. That's hard. And you can't do it. No matter how hard you try, you can't hold on to what you think you have. Not even your own life. You don't possess it. Ultimately. That's hard. That's an impossible task, to try to hang on. And letting go is something we don't even need to try to do. Because one day it'll just happen. And we will let go. We will. Every one of us. So the invitation is to accept that here. And why? Because salt is salty, that's why. Does salt try to be salty? Do we have to do something to salt to make it salty? Does it need anything other than what it is to be salty? He's not talking about salt. He's talking about you and me. He's talking about your essence is there. Your true self is there. And letting go of the things that are deceitful and false and get us into trouble and cause suffering for ourselves and for others because we try to hold on to them because we can't. It can seem scary. That letting go can seem scary. Dying can seem scary. Coming to the end of our life can seem scary. Coming into midlife is scary. That's why they call it a crisis. And we have more and more concrete feeling that everything will go. And even our families. I get it. But the part of us that's scared, the part of us that's afraid, is not the true self. It's that part of us that has attached and has decided this is who and what we are, essential to who and what I am, what we are. We can let go because salt is salty, and you are you. To be human, is to have humanity. To be alive is to experience the eternal life of God. Every form passes away, including this one. Every form passes away, including family, everything we think we have. Every form passes away, but life is eternal. You know, it's funny, I was going to talk about Labor Day today. But it is related because, you know, Labor Day, and we celebrate, we honor honest labor today, laborers. And we know the complicated history of the labor movement. But we know that at the heart of it is something good, which is a view of equality among persons. The view that work, no matter how lowly, is valuable. And those who do it are valuable. And we want to honor that. We want to lift up the lowly. And we want to, you know, maybe bring the high down just a little bit. That's a beautiful vision. That's biblical. It's in Isaiah like crazy. It's in the Magnificat. It's in everything, nearly everything Jesus taught about. So this isn't just an inner work. It's an inner way to help create a better world. Why? Because we've let go. And whether we're high or whether we're low, in the outward scheme of things, this is the work that creates more equity, because we can recognize every self as sacred and not just a means to our ends, which is what so often happens with labor. I'm not sure how to end, but I'm just going to end. I'm just going to say amen. Take, O Take Me As I Am, 814. Please rise for the prayers if you're able. Help us, O God, to be who we truly are, who you have made us to be. Help us to be fearless in letting go of what we cannot keep, so that we may truly live abundantly, freely, fully, loving what you have made and given us so freely, God, in your mercy. For all those who labor in honest work, we pray that they would know their value. And for those who accumulate needlessly, that their hearts may be transformed to become neighbors. Lord, in your mercy. Those in crisis, fire, water, poverty, homelessness, abuse, sickness, lift up the lowly. And may those on high share God in your mercy. Transform our world, even as you transform our hearts. Strengthen communities rooted in in truth and in love and in service. God, in your mercy, for these persons and situations that we now name aloud or in our hearts, into your hands, O breath of our breath, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your everlasting mercy through Christ. Amen. The peace of God be with you always. We share a sign with each other. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for everyone. For forgiveness, the letting go, the letting go, the letting go of sin. Do this and remember me." We'll do call and response, our Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. table is prepared and everyone is welcome. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen and keep us in grace unto life eternal, here and now. Amen. Announcements. We're having a festival on Saturday, I'm sure you're all aware, in the afternoon. Music will be fabulous, and we're gonna have some corn and watermelon. We're gonna have some vegan samples from Colin, Colin won't be there, but, and I think Sue has some signups for us. You have signups for volunteering to set up or to take down or to serve. Those are your options. So if you can be there, if you can give a couple hours, it's a great way to interact with people, obviously. So it should be fun. Hopefully the weather will be good. And we're going to have apple cider tastings from the Maiden Rock Winery and Cidery. So they're going to have a table and a place, and then and I think they're doing kind of a raffle as well. Couple of raffles, and then Burning Brothers are going to be present as well. Walt, and so they're the brewery right over here, gluten-free beer. And they're going to have some samples, and I think a raffle for a growler. So if those are interesting, those will be there, and should be fun. And I think we're starting about one.
No, the live music will be 2 to 6, but at Herdy Basden, who's the Maiden Rock Winery and Cidery Fellow, also has a show on KFAI Radio once every quarter, and he really wants to do it. So he's doing something called Soul Food, a playlist called Soul Food. So imagine
DJ.
What that might be.
That's great.
From 1 o'clock on.
1 o'clock. So 1 o'clock. If you're just there setting up, like with me, then we'll enjoy it together. All right? Was there anything else to announce? Birthdays. Ron?
Mañana.
Ron. Are you 60?
Six.
66, Route 66. It's spelled the same frontwards or backwards. Yeah. Okay. So Ron, who else? Anybody out there? No? Anybody? Ray? It's your birthday? No. All right, for Ron.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Ron. Happy birthday to you. To me.
Okay, everyone, we have a closing number that we call it.
And a friendly reminder to, unless you want to take them home, you are welcome to, but otherwise we're going to try to reuse some of our song sheets.
Oh, yeah.
So our hymn sheets, so there's a basket in the back table, so when you drop off your hymnal.
Basket in the back. And also you can drop off your cups from communion. Sue collects those over there. All right, come and follow me. Please stand if you can.
You come and follow me. Thank you.
May God bless you and keep you. May God's face shine on you and be gracious to you. May God's countenance be lifted up upon you, giving you peace. Amen.
This just in on the wire.
Volunteer.